doing? I'm Anna Intensity. Welcome back to my channel. So today I actually woke up to some pretty exciting news and I was like, geez, I really have to make a video on it just because it's so interesting to me. So basically, you know, Netflix has been really feeling like the anime boom. They're like, you know what? We're gonna make our own anime. And they've been trying, you know, they've been releasing several of their own originals. And now they are actually planning to release 5 more originals in 2019. But these originals really caught my eye because I never expected them to become anime. I really wish I had like a poster or like a trailer of these series, but right now the announcement was just made. So there are no posters, no trailers as of today when I'm filming this video. So I think Netflix has really been feeling the anime boom. They've been feeling just the demand for anime. They see that people watch them. They see that people want to watch anime and that they are popular. They're like, okay, we want a cut of that. So they're actually coming up with some more, like 5 different anime. And honestly, all of them sound really, really cool. And I was looking at the staff and the staff members actually are from Japanese animation studios. So I don't know about you, but I know a lot of people when they're like, oh, a Netflix original anime, blah, blah, blah. And there's always like this kind of argument and whatever. That's another story. But there are actually, you know, Japanese studios behind these new anime that are gonna be Netflix originals. And that really, to me, is a step in the right direction. And I can't wait to see, you know, how these anime series turn out. So the first 2 series are actually going to be anime adaptations of live action series, or things that aren't anime to begin with, basically, because one is technically not a series. But so the first one is actually Pacific Rim. What? Pacific Rim getting an anime? Is this real life? Is it really real life? Pacific Rim is actually getting an anime, and I think that's really, really awesome. So if you didn't know already, Pacific Rim actually has 2 films, and this original anime series is basically going to expand upon them. We're going to follow 2 siblings, a teenage boy and his younger sister, who are forced to pilot an abandoned Jaeger across a hostile landscape in a desperate attempt to find their missing parents. Judging by what I've seen so far, I didn't see like any Japanese studio working on it. The production company is Legendary Entertainment, which has worked on Kong Skull Island and Pokemon Detective Pikachu, which is a live-action film. We do have Craig Kyle from Thor Ragnarok and Greg Johnson from X-Men Evolution. I really enjoyed Thor Ragnarok, so you know what? I'm looking forward to the Pacific Rim anime. I think it sounds like it's gonna be a blast. Honestly, I know a lot of people love Pacific Rim, especially a lot of anime fans love Pacific Rim. I noticed that. And also a lot of kaiju fans also love Pacific Rim. So I think it getting an anime is definitely appropriate. I think it's something that will definitely draw in views because a lot of anime fans, like I said before, love Pacific Rim. So I think that it's going to be a lot of fun. I trust the staff. I think it's going to be really, really good. So I'm really looking forward to the Pacific Rim anime. I know a lot of people are as well. So that's really cool. Moving along to the second anime announcement, it's actually Altered Carbon. I don't know how many of you have actually watched the series on Netflix, but that is the last thing I ever expected to get an anime. Like, I could see, you know, it's definitely sci-fi, like a, you know, cyberpunk kind of thing, but I never expected it to get an anime. Like, it's just, what?
The Altered Carbon anime is set in the same universe of the Netflix live-action sci-fi series. It's actually going to be getting a second season soon, but that's the live-action. We're talking about the anime here. Anyway, so the Altered Carbon anime is basically going to be exploring new elements of the story mythology. Daisato from Cowboy Bebop and Samurai Champloo is going to be writing this series, and Tsukasa Kondo is also going to be working on it. The animation studio is Anima. I'm not too sure which other anime they've released or worked on, but honestly, if Daisato is gonna be the writer, I have high hopes for it.
This anime is another one where I have faith in the staff, the writer, the director, studio. I think it's going to turn out well. I just have to finish the Altered Carbon series. I never finished it because I'm still confused and don't really know what was going on. So I think I really have to give that a rewatch, but honestly, I think it could work. I really think it could work. I think it'll really look nice as an anime. I just, I didn't expect it to become one. Coming at number three is actually an anime that's based off of a manga, so that's really interesting for Netflix to be getting this Netflix original, and it's based on manga, so I actually really, really am looking forward to this one. It's called Kagaster of an Insect Cage or something like that. I've never heard of this series before, but Gonzo is behind this anime. I am for it. I love Gonzo, so I really want to see what they can do. The plot sounds interesting, which I'll get to in a moment, but honestly, I think it sounds interesting.
Okay, so yeah, this one is definitely based on a manga, but I have never heard of it. But basically, it's set in a post-apocalyptic world where a mysterious disease, Kagaster, turns people into giant murderous insects. Like, that sounds like my worst nightmare. This sounds... I don't like the way this anime sounds, but at the same time, it sounds really cool. But it follows the struggle of a young couple to stay alive against people that turn into bugs. That is intense. It's going to be directed by Koichi Chigida, who worked on Last Exile and Full Metal Panic. So if it's anything like that in terms of tone or the way that it's directed, I think I'm really going to enjoy it. And of course, the animation studio is Gonzo, who's also worked on Afro Samurai and Helsing. So that's really awesome. And I think this one is going to be a hit. I'm looking forward to it.
I guess we'll have to see how that goes, but I believe in Gonzo. I really like a lot of Gonzo anime, so I think that they could actually make this anime really, really good. So now we have a really good writer and stuff like that. So I think that, you know, this is another series that seems promising. Coming in at number four, this is the one that I'm looking forward to the most, actually, and that's called Yasuke. And this one is actually being worked on with MAPPA, LaShawn Thomas, and a bunch of other cool people, and it just sounds so awesome. I was like, I am for it. It's like a, I don't know, like Oda Nobunaga, and like, oh, it sounds really, really cool. Check it out.
So Yasuke is actually kind of funny because I thought that it was actually like a typo. I was like, is this supposed to be Yusuke instead? But then I realized it's not Yu Yu Hakusho. But anyway, in a war-torn feudal Japan of mechs and magic, a retired ronin must take up his sword when he is charged with the task of transporting a mysterious child who dark forces want to eliminate. I don't know, something reminds me of Moribito when I read that plot. I was like, okay. I like where this is going. It's created and directed by LaShawn Thomas, who has created some really awesome things, so I really think that this should be pretty interesting. He's also working as the executive producer. Flying Lotus will be composing the music, who is based on the historical samurai of African origin who fought with Oda Nobunaga. Like, if that doesn't sound cool, honestly, I don't know what cool is. I really think that this anime is going to be really awesome.
I really wish there was like some kind of preview or something for that, because I think that it sounds like fire. Honestly, I cannot wait to watch that series. I think it sounds promising. I really, really am looking forward to this anime the most, and I hope it turns out to be awesome. The last anime is actually called Trace? I don't know how exactly you pronounce the title of this anime, but this one actually takes place in the Philippines, which I think is different, and I think that's cool. Different is cool. I never expected an anime series of that kind, and the plot sounds interesting, and just the whole setting is different, so I'm looking forward to that one as well.
So Trisei, I don't know. I can't really say it. I really need like a pronunciation. But anyway, this is actually taking place in Manila, the Philippines. So it's set in Manila, where the mythical creatures of Philippine folklore live in hiding amongst humans. Alexandra Trees finds herself going head to head with a criminal underworld comprised of malevolent supernatural beings. And it's based on the Philippine graphic novel by the same name, created by Bujet Tan and Kajo Baldissimo. So I think this sounds really different and really cool. I like how we're getting something based on a Philippine, you know, comic. Like, that sounds really, really cool. It's something different. It's also not going to be made by a Japanese studio, but it's produced by Shanti Harmain and Tanya Yuson at Base Entertainment, a studio based in Jakarta and Singapore. So I like how other Asian studios are being represented. I think that's really awesome. So I like magic, I like supernatural beings, and I think it sounds interesting, but I would like to see more about it.
So those were the So those were 5 upcoming anime coming to Netflix in 2019. I'm pretty sure they have more projects up their sleeve. They're just not telling us right at the moment. But honestly, I think all these series sound very, very promising. And I want to know which anime out of these 5 are you the most excited for? Because they're definitely, definitely different topics, different subjects, different studios that are going to be working on each anime. So I want to know, which one are you most likely to watch? I think I really want to watch Yasuke. That sounds awesome. But anyway, I hope you enjoyed this news. I know I'm happy. I think Netflix is like, hey, we want a slice of that cake, so we're going to keep on making our own anime because we see that people like to watch anime and they're like, we want our share. So I think it's still a great step in the right direction, and especially to see that actual like anime studios from Japan are working on these Netflix originals. I really, really like that. So anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. Totally, totally appreciate it. Please like, share, or subscribe if you like this video, and I will see you guys next time.